Welcome back, everybody, to Let's Play System Shock. Oh, it has been way too long. I miss this game. I really do. Also, even though it was so... Thank you. Even though it was so long ago, I do remember what I have to do. I remember that this door led up to a dead end of floor 8. So, no worries. I remember what to do, just not how I'm supposed to cut. See, there's gotta be some next... No. Let's see, where's some elevators? There's one over there. Actually, it looks like that might be the only elevator I can find. Well, that doesn't seem too good. Then again, it looks like I might not have explored this area fully. So there's that. Looks like there might be something down here, too. Not sure what. Okay, so I gotta go. Thank you! Northwest, into that little corner. I do not remember this map layout. Fortunately, I have a little mini-map. So, yeah, I've been kind of busy with holidays and stuff going on over at the, I mean, I work in a freaking grocery store. I am a little ashamed to admit that, but guys gotta pay rent somehow. And, oh, come on. Oh. Okay. Thank you, Mr. Floaty Elevator. Okay, this is what I want. Now, I can't go to 4-8 with that. Damn. Okay, well... I just gotta kind of my way through and okay, this is what is this strange and unusual place that I discovered? Oh. Just this place? Well, medkit and some ammo won't go unmissed. Not that I actually have the weapon for any of that anymore. Let's see. Yep, I'll take them. So how on earth... I think I've cleared out all the security. And I'm pretty sure I have to go to floor 8 before I do anything else. I even sure if that really does anything. Yeah, it might just be something weird going on with the map. Oh, forgot. Can't just tap out of crouch. No, no. Can't have that. Too logical for this old cave game. The hell do I do? Well, I mean, as far as I can tell, the only other place I probably can go is, in fact, floor 6. I might have to go down a few floors and find a different elevator. I'm just not too sure what I'm supposed to be doing here. Welcome back, everybody, to Let's Play System Shock, where we make absolutely no progress whatsoever, multiple playthroughs over and over. Sounds about right. Is there anything down here? No, this is just where I blew that one thing up. I miss blowing things up. Speaking of blowing things up, so I haven't actually forgotten about, Lords of the Fallen either, but, I mean, it's really just not that fun, and, I'm not entirely sure how everybody else would even feel about me just continually frustrated and bored out of my mind with how it is. Again, beeping, please. Just don't. Yeah, okay, I don't even need that. I am amazed that all the way from here I can solve that wire puzzle. Like, I don't know, Stretch Armstrong or something. Oh, I remember this. This is the, room of kinda sorta bullshit. And this is the room of pleasant, sweet dreams. Seriously, they... I've played a little bit of System Shock 2. I don't think I ever made it out of the medical bay, but I really felt like I kind of wanted to get to this one first. Kind of actually glad I did, if I'm gonna be honest, because, you know, just because something's old doesn't mean it's bad. Although that said, number 8. Alright, got it. But yeah, as I was saying, sometimes it's just like, you get so used to a lot of the newer stuff that, you know, like how with, something can just kind of show up on a screen here, but it's not quite as obvious for information that you need. The, I think it was that, med lab code, or, one of the codes from, like, the very beginning of the playthrough. What was it? Reactor code? Ah, I can't remember. But anyway, yeah. I do remember wandering around and not knowing really what the hell I was supposed to be doing, but... some kind of, like, executive elevator or something that I wasn't able to get to. Can't remember if this was it. Oh, we're using the executive elevator. Okay, well, never mind that. Still haven't been able to get to these doors. But I think those are life pod doors, and in order to actually activate those, I still need to get to floor 8. This is one of the reasons why I do wish there was some kind of a objective list. I hear some kind of carpet thingy going vroom vroom. Only this game can make a vacuum cleaner sound on set. I'll give it credit for that. This is probably the only game where I've been attacked by a killer Roomba. Because, I swear, I go up here. Can't be used. Door's locked. Slab, slab. Yeah, door is locked. Nope. That's all software. this is about what I expected it was. Seriously? Okay, well... Anyway, that's not what I, logs.
I've made it. I'm on the security level, but it's a fortress. Elevator's gone. Have to go up the central shaft of the bridge. There's a control here somewhere that activates the force bridge across the shaft.
Okay, but how do I open up the door? Executive maintenance. Also, really wish that these were titled better, something simpler to understand. Yeah.
You disappoint me, my children. My fortress has been breached.
Shodan's got complete control of the system. We can't override him. He's keeping the codes from us. If we could just shut down the CPUs on levels 1 through 6, then we could. Yeah, that would do it. The question is, how do we do it? We can't send strike teams to disable the CPUs on those 6 floors. We can't even defend ourselves. Richie out.
Right, so we need the CPUs. Fair enough. How do I open up a door? Door is locked. Well, kinda wish I could. So yeah, therein lies my entire problem.